Hey guys, what's up? It's FlareBeOne, and I'm here to do my top 5 best animes that I've seen, because I haven't seen all the animes. You can put your top 5 in the comments below, because, you know, it's freedom of speech here. It's freedom of speech in America, if you live in America, but I'm giving you that freedom of speech, you know. But anyway, let's calm down for a minute, and let's get on with my top 5 now. Number 5 has to be Rosario Vampire, and the reason why is because that was one of the first animes that I've seen with more comedy than action. I mean, it has some good action, but it also has some more comedy, and it has some more, like, funny moments than, like, other animes that I've seen. And I've seen, like, some good animes, and this one was just really good. Like, it didn't have to have, you know, action and just, like, blood spewing. But, okay. This dude's like, alright, now let him out of the thing. But anyway, what I was talking about, like, the blood, like, it doesn't have to have action, like, to the point where it's, like, dark and gritty. Like, it doesn't have to have that type of action to keep me going. And that's what I liked about it. And it was so popular to me that I went to see the manga, and then I went back because the manga was kind of shit at the point. And, like, say what you want about the manga's great, the manga's doing great, and it's like, I don't care, you know, the fucking manga is, like, weird. When they go into an arc that is boring as hell, I'm not gonna read the manga. Like, I'm sorry, but I'm not gonna be like, oh my god, I'm looking forward to this one with, like, the war where he finally beats Aqua or something. Like, I lost interest in the manga. And the fact that it's not a season 3 kind of makes it in the top 5, or makes it number 5. Because if it had a season 3, season 3 would have probably been, like, the best season of Rosario Vampire. And it would have got, like, way more, and I don't know. But yeah. So, anyway, number 4 on my list is Sword Art Online. Now, my friend, Tyler, actually showed me this anime when Shane was here. And Tyler is basically Shane's brother. So, you know, his big brother showed me Sword Art Online. And, you know, it was good at first, and then I started getting into it, and I was like, oh shit, I was like, this should be a game. That was a mistake. But, you know, it was a great anime. That shit was cool. And the reason it's number 4 is because, you know, there are 3 other slots that have those parts. I mean, I would put it up, but there's just those other animes that I think are better. But, you know, it's just great. It's got that action that keeps me going. It's got love, it's got drama. I mean, it just doesn't have sex, which is okay, you know. Not all animes have sex. I don't think any anime has sex, unless it's like hentai or something. But yeah, it's a great anime. I loved every bit of it. I haven't seen season 2 yet. I want to, but I'll probably have to see it, like, when it goes on Netflix or something, because I don't think I'm just going to search it up. Oh, season 2 of Sword Art Online. Like, no, I can't do that. Especially with the laptop I have, that thing's a piece of shit, so I'm not gonna do that. Alright, now third place of my list is gonna be Dead Man Wonderland. Yep, Dead Man Wonderland. Now, this anime was dark and gritty. And it was actually one of the first animes that I've seen, or that I saw on Toonami. If it wasn't for Toonami, I wouldn't have been talking about this anime, because this anime is just great. Like, oh my god, this anime. I have no words for that anime. Like, the characters, just the overall plot, the artwork. I mean, I have no words to say for Dead Man Wonderland right now. I mean, I would put it on first place, but I can't. Because, you know, I heard that there will be a season 2 coming next year. Because there was like a list or something. Something. I don't know. I mean, it had low ratings in Japan, which is why I didn't have a season 2. But, you know, people are still talking about it to this day. So, might see that season 2. Alright, anyways, let me get to number 2. Number 2 has to be Naruto. Naruto! That's that anime. That's the anime that is just nostalgic. Because I remember, like, as a kid, I would just sit down, just sit on my ass and just watch Naruto. Just watch it. And I remember I had, like, the headband. I had, like, all the costumes at one point, and then I lost them somehow. I don't even know what happened to them. But, like, I remember I would, like, fight my cousin as Sasuke, and my cousin would be Naruto, and we would just be facing off because of that one fight that they had that it was, like, it was just powerful. And, you know, still to this day, you know, the anime's been really good. I mean, there are all some boring arcs that, you know, make me want to go to sleep, but, you know, there are also some arcs where it's like, alright, Yeah, keep going, and, you know, it's sad that it's gonna end, like, the actual series, the manga series, is gonna end in about, 3 or 4 weeks, because that's, like, your childhood. Like, if you're me, and you were 7, and you were watching, like, the Naruto and Sasuke fight, and you're seeing what they're doing now, and the fact that it ends in, like, 3 or 4 weeks, it's like, wow. It's like, it's nostalgic, but it's also like, what's gonna happen after that? It's like, there's gonna be no more Naruto. I mean, maybe they'll get like another series or something. Maybe they'll do like a sequel series. I mean, I don't know. Anyway, taking the first place on my list. First place. Now, Naruto didn't get first place. That should put something in your head. That an anime is better than Naruto. Yeah, that was kind of weird. Anyway. The anime that's got first place is going to be Hunter x Hunter. Hunter x Hunter. Now, I'm kind of trying to like think of an explanation. But, I came into the show not expecting shit. Like, I expected the show to be, like, a Naruto ripoff. And, like, the fact that it was made before Naruto means that Naruto is kind of a ripoff of Hunter x Hunter. Except, it's just, like, Naruto's just better than Hunter x Hunter. Because, I'm not gonna get into that. The reason why it's first place is because the characters are just great. Like, the characters, it reminds me a lot of Naruto. They have a lot of specific elements that relate to Naruto and all that. It's like, you can't watch Hunter x Hunter, and if you watch Naruto, you can't, like, compare Naruto and Hunter x Hunter. It's just impossible. But it's the fact that Hunter x Hunter wins in almost every way. Like, every comparison I've put with Naruto and Hunter x Hunter, Hunter x Hunter won. It won. My favorite character probably has to be Hisoka. The Orochimaru looking guy. He doesn't look like him, but, you know, he has a personality. And that's why everything, like, I look at the anime, and I'm like, okay, Killua Sasuke, Gon's a lighthearted version of Naruto. Not saying that Naruto's not lighthearted. Ging is like the asshole Minato. Not saying he's an asshole, but it's like the asshole version of him. The mom, I haven't seen his mom yet. I'm not that far in it yet. I'm on season 4. Actually, I am pretty far. But like, I haven't got to the Chimera Ant arc, so I don't know. Like, he hasn't met Ging yet. You know, Gon hasn't. I mean, I don't even know. But I'm willing to finish it. I'm going to try to finish it this week, because I have a 4-day weekend. But that was my first place. That was my top 5. Sorry. But, yeah, Hunter x Hunter is first place, Naruto second place, third place is Danmei Wonderland, fourth place is Sword Art Online, and fifth place is Rosario Vampire. So, that is my top five. If you agree with my list, well, great. It's good. It's very good. But, if you don't, well, just put your own. Just, like, put your own. And if you like it and you want to put your own anyway, put your own, you know. Freedom of speech in this place. This place called Flare Bones Channel. So, be sure to like, favorite, well, not favorite, because, you know, there's this thing called, favoriting and not watching the video. Just be sure to, like and subscribe. Don't favorite the video, because then you won't, like, see it. You just favorite it, and then you won't see it for a while. Because I know that happened to me, where I favorited a video, and basically, it was like a year or two before I went back to it. So I think it's just good to like and subscribe. Just like and subscribe the video. Like the video, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. And, you know, thanks for stopping by and shit, you know? It's good to have a company. I'm alone in here, see? It's like, I'm alone. Very lonely.